Once more, greetings everyone. Greetings in the name of Jesus Christ. I hope I find you well, my brothers and sisters. It is an honor and a privilege that I can share the word of God with you today. And I hope and trust that I find you well, as I am well. So, the word of God prevails, and we continue. Word of God, I don't know if I'm clear. Am I clear? I don't know if I'm clear. Am I clear? Testy, am I clear? I hope somebody will indicate to me that my audio is very clear. So, go and test it in the passage. Maybe I'll show you that it's clear. Is it clear? Because I'm using a new gadget, and I'm not sure if it's going to be clear. Go and test it in the passage if it's clear. I want just to hear if it's clear. On Facebook. It's not nothing. I'm live already. Just go to my. Is it clear? Somebody's there. I can see someone. Yeah, okay. So I am live now. So I indicated during the course of the week that I will be sharing the word of God concerning the issue of Apostle Paul and the Sabbath. And I want to make a disclaimer that I indicated that I was going to read from Scripture and prove from the Word of God that Apostle Paul never, ever kept the Sabbath the way we are led to believe, the way things are portrayed by the Seventh-day Adventists, that Jesus Christ, Apostle Paul, and the disciples, they kept the seventh day holy. And I'm going to indicate using Scripture. So what I'm going to do today, I'm going to do a lot of Bible reading. And I will prove that there was no such a thing in the New Testament as keeping the seventh day holy. Someone show me from the Bible, or write down on the space, where from the book of Matthew to the book of Revelation, we see the law keep the seventh day holy. Or we see an instruction binding people to go to church on the seventh day. There is no such a binding. There is no such a verse. So, what I am going to do, before I prove what I came to do tonight, which is to prove that Apostle Paul, Jesus Christ, and the disciples, they did not keep the law, I want to give an advert for what I am going to share next week. I want to prove from Scripture that the law ended. Officially, God ended the law. So what I am going to do, I'm just going to give you verses which show that the law ended. And then next week, I am going to tackle those verses and show you the time and the place and how the law ended. Now, if you understand The verses I'm just going to give as an advertisement that the law ended. You will understand what I'll be talking about next week. I want us to go to the book of Jeremiah, chapter 3, verse 16. Read for us the book of Jeremiah, chapter 3, verse 16. The law ended. So I am not going to be preaching about it. I'm just showing you that the law ended. Jeremiah, chapter 3, read for us verse 16. Okay, read from, start reading from verse, okay, let me read from verse 15. And I will give you pastors according to my heart, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding. This is Jeremiah chapter 3, verse 15. And verse 16. And it shall come to pass, when you be multiplied and increased in the land, in those days, says the Lord, they shall say no more the ark of the covenant. In those days, they shall not say anymore the ark of the covenant. What was the ark of the covenant? The ark of the covenant was where the ten, where the tablets of God were, and the ten commandments were written there in Mount Horeb. So now God says there is coming a time when the Ark of the Covenant shall be deleted. I'll explain what I mean by that. So let me just read this. And it shall come to pass, when you be multiplied and increased in the land, in those days, says the Lord, they shall say no more the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord. Neither shall it come to mind, neither shall they remember it, neither shall they visit it, neither shall that be done anymore. What was the Ark of the Covenant? The Ark of the Covenant was the law of Moses, where the Ten Commandments were sealed. Now here in Jeremiah chapter 3 says there is coming a time when it will not be remembered. And if you don't understand, I will vindicate this verse with another verse. Lamentations verse chapter 2 verse 6. Lamentations 2 verse 6. The law was going to come to an end officially. God was going to finish it or was going to end it. So, Lamentations, chapter 2, verse 6. Okay, Jeremiah 3. Let me just go to Jeremiah 3 and check something. Lamentations 2, verse 6. Can you read for us? Lamentation 2, verse 6.
He has laid waste his dwelling like a garden. He has destroyed his place of meeting. The Lord has made Zion forget the appointment, festivals, and the Sabbaths. In his fierce anger, he has pruned both king and priest. The Lord has rejected his order and abandoned his sanctuary. He has given the walls of the palaces into the hands of the enemy. They have raised a shout in the house of the Lord as on the day of an appointment festival.
Okay. Lamentations chapter 2 verse 6, I'll read. And he has violently taken away his tabernacle, as if it were of a garden. He has destroyed his places of the assembly. The Lord has seized the solemn feasts and Sabbaths to be forgotten in Zion. So there is coming a time. These were the days of lamentation. It says there is coming a time. We saw in Jeremiah 3 verse 16, where it says there is coming a time when the Sabbath and these feasts will be forgotten. And then here in Lamentations 2 verse 6, it says the Lord has violently taken away his tabernacle, as if it were of a garden. He has destroyed his places of the assembly. The Lord has caused these feasts and Sabbaths to be forgotten in Zion. I know, as I indicated These verses, I am not going to explain. I'm just giving you highlights. I know you will have question marks with these verses. Let us continue again. I give you another one. Hosea chapter 2, verse 11. Hosea chapter 2, verse 11. I'm just going to show you verses which show that the Sabbath, God promised that he was going to delete it. It was not going to be hid again. Hosea chapter 2, verse 11. Are you there?
I will stop all the celebrations, the yearly festivals, the new moons, the Sabbath days, all the appointed festivals.
Okay, let me read also. I think you might not be clear since you are far away from the mic where I am. 541. Hosea chapter 2 verse 11. That's a promise that the Sabbath was going to be deleted by God forever. Hosea chapter 5 verse 11. Sorry? Hosea chapter 2 verse 11, sorry. I'm there. Hosea 2:11. I will cause all her myth to cease, her feast days, her new moons, and her Sabbaths, and all her feasts. The new moon, the Sabbath, the moon, the feast have stopped. But now in Hosea, it had not stopped. God was saying it's a future event which I am going to do. This is the reason why when you read from Matthew chapter 1 to Revelation chapter 22, you don't see anywhere where the Bible instructs us to keep the seventh day or to observe the seventh day or to go to church on Saturday. There is no such a command. Why? Here in Hosea chapter 2 verse 11, some 3,000-4,000 years ago, God said I was going to cause it one day to stop. I'll read again. I will also cause all your myth. I don't know what version you have. Let me sorry? Yeah, read the NIV.
I'll stop all your celebrations, the yearly festivals, the new moons, the Sabbath days, all the appointed festivals.
So, what is hard with such a simple, straightforward statement where God says, I will stop the new moons, the festivals, the celebrations, the law of Moses? There is coming a day when I am going to stop it. Is this a hard statement to grasp? This is a promise. God says, there is coming a time I am going to stop it. We saw in Jeremiah chapter 3 verse 11, where it says, God says, there is coming a time when the new moons, the law will cease. Okay, let me read again. Another verse. Amos chapter 8 verse 5. I told you that I am giving you highlights of verses which show that the law of Moses and the Sabbath ended. But now here, we were taking, or we are given the promise before it happens. So as I promised you, I am going to show you in the next series how, when it ended, the law. Amos chapter 8 verse 5. Read for us.
When will, let me start from verse 4. Hear this, you who tremble the need and do away with the poor of the land, saying, when will the new moon be over, that we may sell grain, and the Sabbath be ended, that we may market wheat, skipping on the measure, boosting the price, and cheating with dishonest scales.
Continue.
Buying the poor with silver and the need for a pair of sandals.
Okay, here is Israel. They're asking, when is the Sabbath going to end? So, meaning, they had a perspective that one day the Sabbath was going to end. Now, we saw in the other, in Hosea chapter 2, verse 6, where it says, it is going to end. So, I'm just showing you verses which show that the Sabbath one day was going to end. It's a promise from God that the Sabbath was going to end. So now I've shown you in Hosea chapter 2 verse 11. I will read again and then go back to the verse I read, show you again, and then read the other verse. And then I'll continue now. I've highlighted what I will do next week. So I know these verses will confuse you, but don't worry. I will explain in detail next week. But all I am trying to show you right now is that the Sabbath ended according to the word of God. It's not an accident that the Sabbath ended. You never hear Jesus keeping the Sabbath. That is the reason why you hear Jesus was saying, the Sabbath was made for what? It was not made, man was not made for the Sabbath. The Sabbath, okay, let me quote it the way it was put. The Sabbath was made for men and not made for the Sabbath. Okay, let me quote it. Mark 2, verse 27, read for us. Mark 2, verse 27. I am just showing you some introductory parts of the Sabbath that it ended. But now, if you understand this verse, Mark 2, verse 27.
And he said unto them, the Sabbath was made for men, and not men for the Sabbath.
What did Jesus mean by that statement? The Sabbath was made for men, and not men for the Sabbath. What was he talking about? He was saying, man is superior to the Sabbath. Man cannot be ruled by the Sabbath. The Sabbath is under man. I will explain that again next week. Now, today I came to show you that we say Apostle Paul, Jesus Christ, and the disciples, they went to the temple or to the synagogue to keep the Sabbath. That is not what the Bible teaches. Write down. Amos 8 verse 5. The Sabbath is coming to an end one day. Write down Hosea chapter 2 verse 11. God says one day the Sabbath is going to end and is going to end it. Write down Jeremiah chapter 3 verse 16. One day the Sabbath is going to end. Write down Jeremiah 31 verse 31. One day the Sabbath is going to end. And keep those verses in your memory or do some research. Now, why did the Sabbath end? How did the Sabbath end? Therein comes my question and the answer that Paul did not keep the Sabbath. So now, why did the Sabbath end? Now, mind you, I did not explain that how it ended. But I am just trying to show you that it ended so that I deal with Paul that he didn't keep it because it had ended. So let us go to Hebrews chapter 7 verse 18. The Sabbath ended. But now I am not showing you the end of the Sabbath. I am showing you why it ended so that you will understand that Paul did not keep it. I hope you are with me. I am saying, I gave you a background to show you that the Sabbath ended in the Old Testament.
The former regulation is set aside because it was weak and useless. For the law made nothing perfect, and a better hope is introduced by which we draw near to God.
Read it again.
The former regulation is set aside because it was weak and useless. For the law made nothing perfect, and a better hope is introduced by which we draw near to God.
Okay, let me read from this version. Hebrews chapter 7, verse 18. Why the law of Moses ended? The Bible says it ended because it was weak and... That, what is the other word you choose? Your inner vision. Weak and useless. According to Hebrews chapter 7, verse 18, the reason why God was making a promise that one day the law was going to end, it was because the law was weak and useless. Hebrews chapter 7, verse 18, I will read. For there is verily a disannulling. Of the commandment going before, for the weakness and unprofitableness thereof. One version, let me put it, what one version says, very simple version. It says, let me show you what one simple version says about the uselessness of the law and its end. It says, the law was weak and useless. Why was it weak and useless? Romans chapter 3 verse 19. Why was the law weak and useless? Romans 3 verse 19. So I will give you some background information of why the law ended and why Paul didn't keep it. Because it was useless and it didn't help anyone. Romans 3 verse 19.
Now we know that whatever the law says, it says to those who are under the law, so that every mouth may be silenced and the whole world held accountable.
Mm-hmm. Verse 20.
Therefore no one will be declared righteous in God's sight by the works of the law. Rather, through the law we become conscious of our sin.
So no one is justified by observing the law. So do you mean to tell me that when Romans 3 verse 20 says no one is justified by observing the law, did Paul then go and keep that law? Common sense. If Paul wrote down to the Romans, he says, Romans, I want you to know that no one is justified by observing the law. So do you mean to tell me that if that is what he wrote, was he going to keep that law? I am going to answer the question where people say he went to the temple. Yes, Paul went to the temple, but did he go to observe the law? No. So Romans 3, verse 20, shows that people are not justified by observing the law. Why? Hebrews 7 verse 18. The law was useless. It was weak. Read Hebrews chapter 7 verse 18 and say ESV Bible. Just say Hebrews, Google Hebrews chapter 7 verse 18 and put ESV. Or let me do it myself. Hebrews 7 verse 18 ESV. Listen to this. For on the other hand, a former commandment is set aside because of its weakness and uselessness. For the law made nothing perfect. So the law was set aside and it was useless. Is that in your Bible? If it's in your Bible, say amen. If it is in your Bible, say amen. Why? Hebrews 7 verse 18. For on the other hand, a former commandment is set aside because of its weakness and uselessness. For the law made nothing perfect. But on the other hand, a better hope is introduced, through which we draw near to God. So there is a better hope which is introduced, the new covenant. Why? The old was weak and useless. Hebrews 7 verse 18. I will give you another verse which supports it. Listen to this. Hebrews 7 verse 18. For on the other hand, I will repeat, a former commandment is set aside because of its weakness and uselessness. We saw in Jeremiah 3, 16, Hosea, Amos, Lamentation, that one day God says, I am going to put it to an end. Why? Because it was useless. Now listen to this. Romans 8 verse 3. Can you read for us Romans 8 verse 3? I will answer the issue of Paul going to the temple that he was keeping the commandments. No. Or the Sabbath. Romans 8 verse 3.
For what the law was powerless to do, because it was weakened by the flesh, God did by sending his own son in the likeness of sinful flesh to be a sin offering. And so he condemned sin in the flesh.
Hallelujah. What is the meaning of Romans 8 verse 3? For God has done what the law weakened by the flesh. Do you see that? We saw that in Hebrews 7 verse 18. That says the law was what? Weak and what? Useless. Here in Romans 8 says, for God has done what the law weakened by the flesh. So the law was weakened by the flesh. It could not save anyone. Why? The law was weak. It could not save anyone. That's why God had to do away with it. I will show you when he did it. Hebrews 7 verse 11. Now, if perfection had been attainable through the Levitical priesthood, well, that is the law, for under it the people received the law, what further need would therefore there have been for another priest to arise after the order of Melchizedek? So do you see that Melchizedek and the law of Moses were two different things? And then he says, rather one named after the order of Aaron. For where there is a change in the priesthood, there is necessarily a change in the law as well. So the law changed. God does not change. God does not change. But his law changes. John 1 verse 17. God does not change. But his law changes. Can you read for us John 1 verse 17? The law of Moses and grace.
For the law was given through Moses. Grace and truth came through Jesus Christ.
The law was given by who? By Moses. Grace and truth by who? By Jesus. Mutemo wakauya na Moses. Asi nyasha nechokwadi zvakauya na Jesu. Mutemo wakanga usira basa, wanga uri useless, wanga uri weak. Romans Hebrews 7 verse 18. Read Hebrew. Okay, let me read verse 19, which vindicates verse 18. It says, Hebrews 7 verse 19, it says, for the law made nothing perfect. But on the other hand, a better hope is introduced through the new covenant. 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 18. You know, I haven't started preaching about what I came for. I'm just giving you a foundation a background information of what way I am going about the law, that the reason why Paul didn't keep it, it was useless. I'm showing you. 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 8. Can you read for us 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 8?
For physical training is of some value, but godliness is value for all things, holding promise for both the present life and the life to come.
Okay. Hebrews 13 verse 9. Galatians 3 verse 17. Galatians 3 17. I know this one, people might not get this one. So I will explain when I talk about how the law ended.
What I mean is this: the law introduced 430 years later does not set aside the covenant previously established by God and thus do away with the promise.
What was the covenant which the law came to substitute 430 years later? Abraham. Meaning, after 430 from the period of Abraham, that's when the law came. And it was not coming to make people righteous. It was coming to make people aware of their sins. That is the reason why Hebrews 7 verse 18 says it was weak and useless. Why? It only announced the weaknesses of people. Mutemo wainga taridza zvibi, wanga usinga zvibvisi. Let us continue. Galatians 4 verse 21. Ndi Paul ari kunyora. This is Apostle Paul writing. So answer the question, if this person is writing this, would he have kept himself under that law?
Tell me, you who want to be under the law, are you not aware of what the law says?
Tell me, you who desire to be under the law, do you not listen to what the law says? So do you think this person who was writing this was under that law? I am coming to answer the question, was Apostle Paul under the law of Moses or the Ten Commandments? Or when he went to the synagogue, was he going to keep it? Because many people say, hey, Apostle Paul went to the synagogue. Jesus went to the synagogue to observe the law. That is not what they wanted to do. Now, I am starting now. You can now start writing notes, because I was trying to show you that Apostle Paul was writing letters about the law, and nothing good was he writing about the law. He was saying, you want to be under the law. The law was weak. Am I telling the truth or not? I have shown you in Hebrews 7, 18 that Paul says the law was weak and useless. So how can Paul commit himself to something which is weak and useless? You be the judge. I continue. First Corinthians chapter 9 verse 19. Yay! Apostle Paul went to the synagogue. Jesus went to the synagogue as his tradition was. Did they go there to keep the law? Let us answer the question. First Corinthians chapter 9 verse 19.
Belong to no one. I've made myself a slave to everyone,
mm-hmm.
to win as many as possible.
Mm-hmm.
To the Jews, I became like a Jew to win the Jews. To those,
okay, he says, to the Jews, I became like a Jew. How? By going to where? To the what? To behave like a Jew is go to what? To the temple, because these Jews, they were under the law, so they went to the temple. And their going to the temple was not observing the Sabbath. They were lost. They thought that going to the temple was observing the Sabbath. Whereas in Exodus chapter 16, verse 28, verse 29, we saw that the true Sabbath, they were supposed to keep themselves indoor. Exodus chapter 16, verse 28 and 29. On the Sabbath day, no one was supposed to go out of the house. So now these fake ones who think that going to church on Saturday is keeping the Sabbath. It is not. This is the reason why Paul says, when I went to the synagogue, I behaved like a Jew. Why? He wanted to win them to what? To Christ. This is 20. We read verse 19 and 20.
Though I am free and belong to no one, I have made myself a slave to everyone to win as many as possible. To the Jews, I became like a Jew to win the Jews. To those under the law, I became like one under the law, though I myself am not under the law.
Hear the a clean, straightforward statement. Andina kuenda kusinagogo kunochengeteza mutemo. Why? Rome Hebrews 7 verse 18. Mutemo wanganga waka uri wiki and useless. Susinga batiri. Saka andina kuenda kuno ubatisa. Am I clear, my dear? Is this clear? Am I clear? That Apostle Paul writes to the Hebrews. He says, the law was weak and useless. And then in 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 10, it says, when I went to the synagogue, I went to win the Jews and the Gentiles. I did not go there to keep the law. Verse 20, read verse 20.
To the Jews, I became like a Jew to win the Jews. To those under the law, I became like one under the law. Though I myself am not under the law.
So Paul makes it clear that I was not under the law of Moses. So where did he keep the law? When I was praying for the SDAs this week, God gave me a verse which I am going to share with the SDAs. The verse which he gave me for the SDAs is the love of the truth. Let me give you the verse. Second Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 10. This is a verse which God gave me specifically to every SDA, especially to those in Zimbabwe. I will read it for you so that it will save your life. And with all deceit of unrighteousness for them that perish, because they received not the love of the truth that they might be saved. Dear my friends, the SDAs, for today only, try to love the truth so that you can be saved. I am showing you 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 20. Paul says, I went to the synagogue to win the Jews. I behaved like them. What did Paul preach when he went to the synagogue? Did he preach about the Ten Commandments? Did he preach about keep the seventh day holy? Did he preach about not eating pork? Did he preach about not touching a shovel on Saturday? What did he preach about? Acts chapter 13 verse 38. When he went to the synagogue, what did he preach about? Did he preach about observing the law? What did he preach about? Acts chapter 13, verse 38. What he preached about when he went to the synagogue, not to keep the Sabbath, but to help those who were under it. Acts 13, verse 38. What he preached.
Therefore, my friends, I want you to know that through Jesus, the forgiveness of sins is proclaimed to you.
Continue.
Through him, everyone who believes is set free from every sin, a justification you are not able to obtain under the law of Moses.
Read again that verse.
Through him, everyone. everyone who believes is set free from every sin, a justification you were not able to obtain under the law of Moses.
Okay. Acts chapter 13, verse 38. Apostle Paul went to the synagogue. Did he preach the Seventh-day Adventist sermon? Did he preach not eating pork or keep yourself pure on Sabbath, on the Sabbath day, and don't work? What did he preach? Listen to what he preached in the synagogue. Be it known unto you, therefore, men and brethren, that through this man is preached to you the forgiveness of sins. Who is that man? Jesus. Verse 39. And by him, all who believe are justified from all things from which you could not be justified by the law of Moses. So the Pharisees, the Sadducees, the Jews were going to the temple and they were not saved. What were they doing? Acts chapter 15 verse 21. To show you what they were doing in the synagogue, which caused them not to be saved. Acts chapter 15 verse 21. Read for us. Acts 15 verse 21.
For the law of Moses has been preached in every city from the earliest times and is read in the synagogues on every Sabbath.
So they were reading the law of Moses every Saturday. What were they reading? A weak and useless law. Am I lying? Hebrews 7 verse 18. The law was weak and useless. So every Saturday, the Pharisees, the Sadducees were lost. That's why Paul went for them. Paul anakwenda ku synagogue. Kunobata sabata. Akaenda kunobatsira vanhu vakanga vari musabata. Vakarasika. I don't know if this is not clear. I have shown you, and I will repeat. Hebrews 7 verse 18. The law was weak and useless. In Acts chapter 13, verse 39, Paul says, Jesus is the one who saves you, not the Sabbath, not the law of Moses. That's why I came here, not to observe what you are observing. Is that clear? Is it clear or it's complicated? So, 2 Corinthians chapter 3. 2 Corinthians chapter 3. 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 3.
You show that you are a letter from Christ, the result of our ministry. Written not with ink, but with the Spirit of the living God. Not on tablets of stone, but on tablets of human hearts.
What is the tablet of stone? The Ten Commandments in Mount Horeb. So now Paul is saying to the Corinthians, you are not under the law. Read that verse again. Read that scripture again.
You show that you are a letter from Christ, the result of our ministry. Written not with ink, but with the Spirit of the living God. Not on tablets of stone, but on tablets of human hearts.
What is Paul talking about? Is he saying keep the Sabbath? He is saying, you are no longer following the tablet commandments. You are following Romans 10 verse 9. For with the heart man believes, and he is justified. This is very simple and clear. When a person tells you that Apostle Paul went to the synagogue to keep the law, they are opposing the Bible. Apostle Paul went to the synagogue. In verse 19, he says, I went there to help those who were bound by the law, which was useless, the law which was weak. Romans chapter 6, verse 14. Romans 6, verse 14.
For sin shall no longer be your master, because you are not under the law, but under grace.
Sin will not have dominion over you. Since you are not under law, but under grace. How many of you, they are under the law? Sin is dominating you. But you are under grace. John 1 verse 17. The law came through Moses. Acts 15 verse 21. In the synagogue, they were preaching about the law of Moses. Because they were lost. But we see, Romans, Hebrews 7 verse 18 says, the law was weak and useless. So how could Paul keep a useless law? I am just trying to simplify the word of God. I am simplifying it so that you understand that we are not under the law. Hebrews chapter 8 verse 6. Hebrews 8 verse 6.
But in fact, the ministry Jesus has received is as superior to theirs as the covenant of which he is mediator is superior to the old one, since the new covenant is established on better promises.
So the new covenant is superior to the old one. So why keep something which is inferior? Read again the verse.
But in fact, the ministry Jesus has received is as superior to theirs as the covenant.
Okay, read verse 4, 5, 6, and 7 so that we understand.
If he were on earth, he would not be a priest. For there are already priests who offer the gifts prescribed by the law. They serve at a sanctuary that is a copy and shadow of what is in heaven. This is why...
Okay, listen. The law was a copy and shadow of what was in heaven. Continue.
This is why Moses was warned when he was about to build the tabernacle. See to it that you make everything according to the pattern shown you on the mountain. But in fact, the ministry Jesus has received is as superior to theirs as the covenant of which he is mediator. Is superior to the old one.
What verse is that? Six. Verse 7.
Since the new covenant is established on better promises. For if there had been nothing wrong with that first covenant.
So if there was nothing wrong with the first. So there is something which was wrong with the what? Continue reading.
For if there had been nothing wrong with that first covenant, no place would have been sought for another.
So do you see that Paul is saying the first covenant was wrong? He even writes to Hebrews 7 verse 18, which I will continue stressing, that it was weak and what? Useless. And then here we see that he says in Hebrews 8 verse 7, if it was okay, if there was nothing wrong, why would God produce another covenant? Is that clear? Read verse 7 again and 8.
There had been nothing wrong with that first covenant. No place would have been sought for another. But God found fault with the people and said, the days are coming, declares the Lord, when I will make a new...
All right. Amos 8, Hosea 2, Jeremiah 3, Habakkuk, where we saw that God says, I am going to finish the what? The law and the Sabbath are going to come to an end. Read that verse again. Read verse 7 and 8. I am trying to go forward. I shouldn't go there. Rejoin next week.
For if there had been nothing wrong with that first covenant, no place would have been sought for another. But God found fault with the people and said, the days are coming, declares the Lord, when I will make a new covenant.
Where did God declare that? I showed you in Amos, in Lamentation, In Hosea, that God says, I am going to take away the Sabbath. I am going to do away with them. This is the reason. When you look from Matthew to Revelation, you don't see anywhere where it says keep the law. Why? It was done away with. I will show you where and how it was done away. Read verse 8.
But God found fault with the people and said, the days are coming, declares the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the people of Israel and with the people of Judah.
Mm-hmm.
It will not be like the covenant I made with their ancestors.
What was the covenant you made with their ancestors? The law of Moses. So he says, a day. Zuva riri kuuya pandichaita chisungo chitsva handizochiitise madzibaba avo vana Moses na Aaron, but it will be a new one. Why? Continue.
It will not be like the covenant I made with their ancestors when I took them by the hand to lead them out of Egypt, because they did not remain faithful to my covenant. And I turned away from them.
I turned away from them because they couldn't keep the commandments. In Exodus 16, keep yourselves in the houses, indoors, on the Sabbath, so-called Sabbath day. They couldn't do it. They were taking manna in a double portion. Why? I will make a new covenant with them. Now, you friends of mine, the SDAs, if you continue the route you are taking, you are going to hell. Love the truth and repent. Romans 3 has shown us that no one is going to be justified by what? By the law. Let me give you another verse. I'll continue. I'm just going to give you scripture. Scripture upon scripture. Nothing okay. Galatians 3, verse 8.
Would justify the Gentiles by faith and announce the gospel in advance to Abraham. All nations will be blessed through you.
Who is a Gentile who is an Israelite today? We are all Gentiles. So how are we put right with God? By what? By faith in Jesus, not by observing the law of Moses. We are put right by God. We are put right to be with God by faith, not by observing the law of Moses. I will give you another verse. I just want to give you scripture. Only, nothing else, nothing more, nothing less. Hebrews 7, verse 19. I will read it again. Hebrews 7, verse 19.
Nothing perfect, and a better hope is introduced by which we draw near to God.
The law made nothing what? Why? Because it was useless and weak. Romans 4, verse 15. Romans 4, verse 15.
Be Because the law brings wrath, and where there is no law, there is no trust.
What does the law bring? So do you think Paul kept it? You think Paul kept the law? When he says it brings kutsamwa kwaMwari, ofukati akauchengetedza. Romans 5 verse 20.
The law was brought in so that the trespass might increase. But where sin increased, grace increased all the more.
The law was brought so that it was...
The law was brought in so that the trespass might increase.
So the law was brought to show... Because it was showing you your mistakes. Once you start having mistakes, you start doing wrong things. So, Apostle Paul went to the synagogue on the seventh day, not to observe the law, 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 19 and 20, but to help those who were trapped in it. Apostle Paul preached grace, and he says, I came to tell you about Jesus, whom the law which you are keeping will not save you from. The Jesus I bring to you is going to save you. Acts chapter 13, verse 38 and 39. Kuti ndauya kuzokuzaya pamusoro paJesu kuti kangani uye zvivi irepo. Mutemo wa Moses. Is that hard to grasp? So if today you didn't get anything, let me just give you one verse which you must get all the days of your life. Acts chapter 13, verse 38 and 39. That only one verse, that's the one I want to leave you with.
Therefore, my friends, I want you to know that through Jesus, the forgiveness of sins is proclaimed to you. Through him, everyone who believes is set free from every sin. A justification you were not able to obtain under the law of Moses.
I wish I could read this in Shona. Let me see if my Shona Bible will allow me. Let me read. What verse is that? Oh, Acts chapter 30. Okay, Acts chapter 13, verse 38. Bible, let's read Shona. I'll read it in Shona. Mabasa. Listen. Mabasa 13, verse 38-39. Verse 38. Naizvozvo varume, hama, muzive imi kuti, kanganwiro yezvivi, no yuyu Jesu, inokuparidzirai, iri inoku paridzirwai imi muri kuparidzirwa nezvikanganiro yezvivi na Jesu mumwe nomumwe unotenda unoruramiswa pazvose zvamakanga musingagoni kururamiswa pazviri nomurayiro waMozisi ndozvanga zvafambira Pauro kutembere kunovaudza kuti kanganiro yezvivi inouya na Jesu kwete nomurayiro waMozisi. That's why he went to the temple. Galatians 2:16 and I close. Galatians 2:16. Read for us Galatians 2 verse 16. I will close with that one.
Know that a person is not justified by the works of the law, but by faith in Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
So we too have put our faith in Jesus Christ, that we may be justified by faith in Christ and not by the works of the law. Because by the works of the law, no one will be justified.
Because by works of the law, no one will be justified. Why? Romans 10 verse 4, Jesus Christ is the end of the law. Simple, straightforward material. I hope and I trust that this is going to help someone. If you don't want the truth, then it's your fault. The law will not save you because Jesus is the end of the law. Thank you.